Good morning all of you. So today we are going to start a new chapter, that is your chapter 2, that is socialism in Europe and the Russian Revolution. So you know, you have already read about French Revolution. So when revolution started in France, there were various other countries that got inspired by it. Okay, so the fire of revolution spread in entire continent. Okay, let's start. The age of social change. In previous chapter, you read about the powerful ideas of freedom, equality that circulated in Europe after French Revolution. So after French Revolution, the ideas of freedom and equality circulated in entire Europe. पूरे यूरोप में फ्रीडम और इक्वालिटी की आइडिया सर्कुलेट होने लगी. पीपल स्टार्टेड रियलाइजिंग दैट एवरीबडी, एवरी ह्यूमन हैज़ राइट टू फ्रीडम. उन्हें भी फ्री होने का हक है. एंड एवरीबडी इज़ इक्वल, नोबडी इज़ अबव और बीनीथ समबडी. कोई ऐसा नहीं है जो पावरफुल है और कोई ऐसा नहीं है जिसको किसी की सुप्रीमेसी में रहने की ज़रूरत है. सो द आइडियाज़ ऑफ फ्रीडम एंड इक्वालिटी स्टार्टेड सर्क्युलेटिंग इन एंटायर यूरोप. द फ्रेंच रेवोल्यूशन ओपन्ड अप द पॉसिबिलिटी ऑफ क्रिएटिंग अ ड्रामेटिक चेंज इन द वे इन विच सोसाइटी वॉज स्ट्रक्चर्ड. सो द वे सोसाइटी वॉज स्ट्रक्चर्ड अर्लियर, इफ यू रिमेंबर द सोशल कंस्ट्रक्ट ऑफ फ्रेंच रेवोल्यूशन, हाउ ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ स्टेट्स डिविजन टुक प्लेस. फर्स्ट स्टेट, सेकेंड स्टेट एंड थर्ड स्टेट, वेयर फर्स्ट टू स्टेट्स इंजॉयड ऑल द प्रिविलेजेस एंड थर्ड स्टेट हैड टू बेयर द डिसएडवांटेज. ओके, सो ऑल दिस यू रेड. नाउ लेट अस सी नेक्स्ट. As you have read before, the 18th century society was broadly divided into states and orders, and it was the aristocracy and the church which controlled economic and social powers. Suddenly, after revolution, it seemed possible to change this. In many parts of the world, including Europe and Asia, new ideas about individual rights which controlled social powers began to be discussed. In India, Raja Ram Mohan Roy and D'Orazio talked of the significance of French Revolution. So after French Revolution, you know, French Revolution is called as the mother of revolution. Okay, after French Revolution, entire world, not only Europe, rather entire world started, or you can say they got inspired by the ideas of equality and freedom. They realized one thing, that it is very, very important to put up your points. Okay, the way it was in other parts of Europe, same was in India also. Raja Ram Mohan Roy and Henry Vivian D'Orazio is his full name, D'Orazio's full name. Henry Vivian D'Orazio, they started talking about the significance of French Revolution, that how French Revolution created or brought change in the French society, how early, since ages, people were suffering on the basis of states. They were segregated, they were divided, they had to bear number of disadvantages. But after French Revolution, if you remember, National Assembly was formed, and how monarchy was changed to constitutional monarchy. Okay. So you know, in India also people, they got very inspired by it, and these ideas were broadly talked by Raja Ram Mohan Roy and Henry Vivian D'Orazio. Now and many other debated the idea of post-revolutionary Europe. The development in colonies in turn reshaped these ideas of social change. So सोशियटल चेंज, जो सोसाइटी की चेंज थी, उसके आइडियाज़ के बारे में पीपल दे स्टार्टेड टॉकिंग अबाउट इट. दे स्टार्टेड डिस्कसिंग दीज आइडियाज़ दैट हाउ चेंजेस आर टेकिंग प्लेस. पहले पोस्ट रिवोल्यूशनरी यूरोप क्या था, रिवोल्यूशन से पहले यूरोप कैसा था, रिवोल्यूशन के बाद क्या क्या पॉजिटिव चेंजेस आए. सो यू नो, रिवोल्यूशन वॉज ग्लोरीफाइड. रिवोल्यूशन को बहुत ग्लोरीफाई करके लोगों ने उसके बारे में बात करना शुरू कर दिया. दे स्टार्टेड टेलिंग दैट हाउ रिवोल्यूशन is good, how revolution is advantageous. If people in France could dare to revolt, even others should. And you know, it is before also I've said you, in earlier videos also I've said you, that it is very, very important to make somebody realize their suffering, and apart from that, to also tell them about their glorious past and the strength that they have. So this was done by Raja Ram Mohan Roy and Henry Vivian D'Orazio. They started telling that, you know, in France post revolutionary Europe kaise tortures mein tha, how monarchy was very cruel over there. Okay, and how after revolution changes had come in people. Now Not everyone in Europe, however, wanted a complete transformation of society. Responses varied from those who accepted some changes were necessary but wished for a gradual shift, to those who wanted restructural society radically. So if you remember, those who were conservative and others were liberals and radicals. So, you know, if you remember in France, society was divided like this, like they were conservatives, liberals or radicals. ठीक है, कुछ लोग ऐसे थे जो बहुत कंजर्वेटिव सोच के थे, जिन्हें लगता था that changes should come but keeping in consideration the tradition. Whereas liberals and radicals were the people who wanted quick change and a complete restructure. They never wanted to continue with the traditional ways. Okay. Conservatives wanted modification in tradition, whereas radicals wanted complete change. Okay. Now, what did these terms really mean in context of the time? What separate these strands of politics and what links them together? We must remember that these terms do not mean the same thing in all the contexts or at all times. We'll look briefly at some of the important political tradition of 19th century, see how they influenced change, then we will focus on historical events in which there was an attempt at a radical transformation of society. Though the revolution in Russia, socialism became one of the most significant and powerful ideas to shape society in 20th century. Okay, so you know, now we'll read that how changes had come, what were the changes like, kaise gradual changes aaye, kaise logo ne changes ko react kiya, all this we'll read. Let us start with the very first topic, that is your topic 1.1, liberal, radicals and conservatives. One of the groups which looked to change society were the liberals. So liberals, liberal का मतलब ही होता है one who appreciate changes. बोलते हैं ना, उसके मम्मी पापा की thought बहुत liberal है. That means they accept to the new things. They accept change. So they looked for a change in society. Liberals wanted a nation which tolerated all religion. We should remember that at this time, European states usually discriminated in favor of one religion or another. Britain favored the Church of England, Austria and Spain. Favored the Catholic Church. Okay, so liberals are basically the people who feel that every religion is important. सारे religion important हैं, ऐसा नहीं है कि कोई religion supreme है या कोई religion उससे below है. They do not believe in such. So at that time, अगर आप जानते होंगे तो जैसे हमारे हिंदुइज्म में various caste divisions हैं, अगर आप जानते हैं हमारे four वर्ण system जो हम follow करते हैं, जैसे ब्राह्मण, क्षत्रिय, वैश्यस और शूद्रस, वैसे ही सारे रिलीजन में सेग्रीगेशन है. जिनके पास पार्स आती थी वो खुद को सुप्रीम मानते थे. ठीक है, सो रोमन्स एंड कैथलिक्स में डिवीजन थे. सो सम ऑफ द यूरोपियन कंट्रीज फेवर्ड कैथलिक्स एंड सम फेवर्ड रोमन्स. ओके, नाउ लिबरल्स ऑल्सो अपोज द अनकंट्रोल्ड पावर ऑफ डायनेस्टिक रूल. They wanted to safeguard the rights of individual against government. They argued for a representative elected parliamentary government. The subject to law interpreted by well-trained judiciary that was independent of rulers and officials. However, they were not democrats. They did not believe in universal adult franchise. This is the right of every citizen to vote. They felt men of property mainly should have vote, and they did not wanted they did not want the vote for women. So now what was the thing with liberals? They wanted parliamentary form of government. They wanted that representative form of government honi chahiye. That means elections honi chahiye and persons should be elected. Elect hoke wo us position pe jaye aur fir उसे पार्लियामेंट में स्पेस दी जाए. दैट मींस कोई भी मोनार्कियल फॉर्म या हेरिडिटरी फॉर्म ऑफ रूल नहीं होनी चाहिए. दैट एक जो मिनिस्टर है या एक जो किंग है उसका सन ही नेक्स्ट हायर बनेगा, ऐसा कुछ नहीं होना चाहिए. बट वन थिंग वाज दैट दे वर नॉट डेमोक्रेट्स. ये इनकी पार्लियामेंट्री फॉर्म ऑफ गवर्नमेंट की थिंकिंग थी, बट दे नेवर हैड अ डेमोक्रेटिक फॉर्म ऑफ, दे नेवर फेल्ट फॉर अ डेमोक्रेटिक फॉर्म ऑफ गवर्नमेंट. दे ऑलवेज बिलीव दैट लोग रिप्रेजेंटेटिव होने चाहिए, इलेक्शंस होने चाहिए, बट इलेक्शंस में इलेक्ट करने वाले भी सेलेक्टेड लोग ही होने चाहिए. एवरीबडी शुड नॉट गेट राइट टू वोट. दे नेवर कंसिडर्ड वुमन एन एक्टिव सिटीजन. अपार्ट फ्रॉम दैट दे ऑलवेज कंसिडर्ड मनीड पीपल, रिच पीपल एज एक्टिव citizen and poor men and all the women, be it from rich section of society or poor section of the society, they were considered as the passive citizens. Now, in contrast, radicals wanted a nation in which government was based on majority of country's population. So above what we read was about the liberals. Now let us read about the radicals. So wanted a nation in which government was based on majority of country's population. Many supposed women's suffrage movement. Unlike liberals, they opposed the privileges of great landowners, wealthy farm factory owners. They were not against the existence of private property, but disliked the concentration of property in hands of few. So now what was with the radicals? Radicals' thoughts were, you know, very different to that of the liberals. Now understand the difference. Liberals wanted that पार्लियामेंट्री फॉर्म ऑफ गवर्नमेंट होनी चाहिए, इलेक्शंस होने चाहिए, बट इलेक्ट जो करेंगे वो केवल वेल्दी लोग होने चाहिए. वुमेन वर नॉट कंसिडर्ड, नो कंसिडरेशन वॉज डन फॉर द राइट्स ऑफ वुमेन. वेयर एज रेडिकल्स दे बिलीव दैट जो भी गवर्नमेंट आए वो मेजॉरिटी से आए, द मेजॉरिटी शुड इलेक्ट द गवर्नमेंट. अपार्ट फ्रॉम दैट दे ऑल्सो सपोर्टेड वुमेन सफरेजिस मूवमेंट, ठीक है, दैट वुमेन को भी वोटिंग राइट्स मिलने चाहिए. एंड दे वर अपोजिंग, दे वर अगेंस्ट द लैंड ओनर्स. जो लोग लैंड ओनर्स थे, फैक्ट्री जो प्रिविलेजेस इंजॉय कर रहे थे उनके वो अगेंस्ट थे. वेयर एज दे वर नॉट अगेंस्ट द प्राइवेट प्रॉपर्टी. ऐसा नहीं था कि किसी के पास बहुत ज़्यादा प्राइवेट प्रॉपर्टी है दैन दे वुड टेक बैक टेक द प्रॉपर्टी. इट वॉज नॉट सो, बट दे वर अगेंस्ट द कॉन्सेंट्रेशन ऑफ द प्रॉपर्टी. एक आदमी के पास बहुत ज़्यादा प्रॉपर्टी से उन्हें प्रॉब्लम थी. ओके, नाउ Conservatives were opposed to radicals and liberals. After French Revolution, however, even conservatives had opened their minds to the needs for change. Earlier in 18th century, conservatives has been generally opposed to the idea of the change. By 19th century, they accepted that some change was inevitable, but believed that the past had to be respected and change had to be brought about through a slow process. So you read about radicals, you read about liberals. Conservatives were purely different from them. Their concept, their thinking was very different to that of the radicals and liberals. Agar aap radicals aur liberals ko dekhenge, both supported elections, ठीक है, बट कंजर्वेटिव्स दे फेल्ट दैट नो इलेक्शन शुड टेक प्लेस. जैसा ट्रेडिशन है वैसी वही ट्रेडिशन कंजर्व होके आगे बढ़नी चाहिए. ओके, सो यू नो आफ्टर दैट व्हाट हैपेंड वाज, बट आफ्टर फ्रेंच रिवॉल्यूशन देयर थिंकिंग हैड ग्रेटली चेंज. उनकी थिंकिंग बहुत ज़्यादा चेंज हो चुकी थी. दे बिलीव कि नहीं, अब चेंजेस आनी चाहिए, बट चेंजेस का जो पेस होगा वो बहुत स्लो होना चाहिए. दे बिलीव दैट चेंज वॉज इनएविटेबल. चेंज ऐसा है जिसे हम रोक नहीं सकते हैं. चेंज, द नेचर ऑफ चेंज इज दैट इट विल टेक प्लेस. सो वी कैनॉट स्टॉप द चेंज, बट चेंजेस शुड टेक प्लेस इन अ वेरी स्लो प्रोसेस. बहुत क्विक चेंज नहीं होनी चाहिए. सच डिफरेंसिंग आइडियाज अबाउट societal changes clashed between society and political turmoil that followed the French Revolution. The various attempts at revolution and national transformation in the 19th century helped define both the limits and potential of the political tendencies. So ye jo clash, itni sari variation thi ideas mein of conservatives, liberals and radicals, ye sara clashes was helped gave a various attempt to revolution. Kabhi liberals active hote, kabhi radicals active hote, kabhi conservatives active hote, बट दैट लेट पीपल नो अबाउट द लिमिट्स एंड पोटेंशियल. बाकी कंट्रीज को बहुत क्लियर हो चुकी थी दैट विच वॉज द राइट वे टू गो अबाउट. ओके, सो इन द नेक्स्ट क्लास वील बी डूइंग योर नेक्स्ट टॉपिक, दैट इज द इंडस्ट्रियल सोसाइटी एंड द सोशल चेंज. सो बाय दैट टाइम वॉट यू हैव टू डू इज दैट देर आर सम वर्ड्स लाइक न्यू वर्ड्स आर गिवेन हियर, एंड अपार्ट फ्रॉम दैट ऑल वॉट आई हैव टॉट यू हैव टू डू फाइंड आउट एनी 5 questions from this and write in your classwork copies. So this was all about it today. Thank you.